Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to create a professional-looking presentation using Microsoft Sway. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So first, to get to Sway, I went to office.com. And I went down here to apps and I scroll down and select Sway. So once we're in Sway, I just want to show you how fast it is to create a presentation. So I'm going to go over here to create new and I'm going to have a title for my Sway. So let's say we want this presentation to be on Microsoft Office and the videos that Microsoft Excel Online has done so far this year. So I'm going to call this Microsoft Office Videos 2022. And then I'm going to click background and you can see that I've already been populated with several images that have to do with Microsoft Office. So I'm going to just pick one of these really quickly. I'd like to go with the Microsoft logo right here. And then I'm just going to click on that when that comes up and hit add. So after I've added that one, I'm going to click in this gray space until I get this plus right here. And now I'm going to hit the plus. And I'm going to add another image. And when I click that image, I'm going to go up here to suggested and go down to my device. I have already downloaded all of the icons of the lessons that we have done this year. So I'm just going to go through and select each one of those by clicking and holding down the control button on my keyboard. And then I'm going to hit open. And if I scroll up, I can see that a whole bunch of cards for each application has already automatically been created over here because I uploaded all of those images. Now I could group all those images together if I would like, but I would like to keep them separate for the purposes of this presentation. So the first thing I'm going to do is go over here to details and get my image right here. And I'm going to select my image and go to the focus points. And I just want to verify that the entire image is important. Box is checked. Otherwise, my image is going to be really huge on the screen. And for this presentation, I do not want that to be the case. If I scroll down here, I can see what the access page is going to look like on my desktop, as well as on a mobile device. So I'm going to go back here, close the image, go over here to caption and type access for data management. And that's going to be my card for access. So I'm going to go down and just put a description in for each one of these applications. Excel for data analysis. I'm going to click on the image by selecting details, image, focus points, and I want to check this box that says the entire image is important. So I'm going to scroll down here to my next card and say OneDrive for file sharing. Click details, click my image, click my focus points, and check this box. So that's the process I'm going to use for each one of these. And finally, I'm on Word, and let me just go over that process for you one more time. I click the caption and say Word for documents. Go to details, click the icon, click the focus points, check this box. Now, if I click in this gray area down here, I'll go back to all of my cards. And what I would like to do is click the add button here, go to one more image, put the Microsoft logo back in, and say, isn't Office great? Okay, so that's my presentation. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So if I go over here to design, so let's say I go up here to styles, and my first choice is I can have a vertical presentation, which flows like a typical web page. I can have a horizontal presentation, which flows side to side, or I can have a slideshow, which is more like PowerPoint. So for this purpose, I'm going to pick slides. And once I hit slides, I get these navigation buttons down here where I'm going to be able to go to the left and the right. So if I do that, I can see that each one is going to be a slide. I can go back to the beginning I'm not really crazy about the layout right here. So what I can do is search some of these themes down here to one that I will probably like a little bit more. And so I'm going to select this style down here, just the basic black, but you can go through, there's tons of styles down here for whatever you like for your personal preference. If I scroll back up here, I can go to customize and I can pick different color palettes or font choices. So let's say I don't really like this font right here. I could just click this down arrow and pick another one. And then I can change my text size. So let's say I'd like that to be a little bit larger. And I can also change my animation emphasis from subtle to moderate to intense. And you can play around with these settings and see what you like best. But for now, let's just go and check this out and see what some of these options look like on screen. So if I go up here to hit play, I can see that my Microsoft first card has shown up. And then I can click through each one of the products right here, and I can talk about what we've done on each one of those. And you can see down here, this is the caption that I put in for each one of the images that I have in my sway. So I'm just going to keep clicking through each one of these, and you can see the black background that I have chosen to in the theme. So I just basically have a page for every single one of the Microsoft products we've done a video on. If you want to go back to design view from here, just hit the back button on your browser. And you can stay on the design screen and you can make some of those subtle changes, or you can just go back to the storyline right here and edit your content. So I could actually add more information here inside my card. So say I click here for access data management and I highlight that and hit emphasize. And then I hit enter and I have another paragraph down here and I'm going to unemphasize that. Access is made up of tables, queries, forms, and reports with flexibility to add code. Okay, so if I go back and play my sway and I go to my second card, I can hit the caption down here and you can see that I can expand to see all that information that I have just added. If I go back again, so let's say I go back to design and I can just change the layout right here. And let's change it to vertical. If I go back to play, now instead of having the slide functionality, I can just scroll down with my mouse and I can see each one of my cards down here and I can see more information on the screen as a whole. So if you like that layout better for what you're working on, you might want to use the vertical or the horizontal style instead of the slide style that we were using. And if I go up here and hit play, I just want to show you the options that are available right here under the settings key. You can control the autoplay speed if you would like. So say you would like your screen to be moving every 3 seconds and you want to have it in slide layout, and I start the autoplay. You can see that my slides are automatically advancing. So if I hit the back button, I get my options again for storyline where I can edit my content. And keep in mind that in my content, I can add more than just text. You can see that I can add a link and I can also click here and add a type of card that lets me add media to my presentation, such as a video or audio. And my other option is to go to design where I can see all my design changes. And once you're done with your sway, and you want someone to be able to view it, just go over here to share, and you have lots of options to share either with a link on social media or even inside of a web page. So hopefully this is a good introduction for you to creating a quick presentation inside Microsoft Sway that does look really nice and slick on the screen. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.